556-5851. Call now and win on the mighty GMA.
The first thing I'm going to have you do, just so we, in case a producer looks at the tape player, I'm going to do a microphone check here also. State your name for us.
Sure.
And just go ahead and state your name for us and spell your last name for us. Also.
I'm John Burwell. That's spelled B-U-R-W-E-L-L, Burwell.
Okay. Your on-air name, was it Johnny Burwell?
No, it was John Burwell. I was one of the few who used my actual name on the radio.
Okay. Okay. And when did you work at the TMA?
I was there from 74 to 1981. January of 81 is when I left.
74 to 81, then, right?
Mm-hmm. From January 74 to January of 81.
Okay. John, tell us, why is TMA so special? We're celebrating 65th anniversary. What makes WTMA such a special radio station?
TMA was one station that was totally consistent all throughout the 60s and 70s. And TMA in the 70s, and well, actually in the 60s as well, had more listeners than any other station in the entire Southeast. You know, and basically what makes a radio station important is the number of listeners that they have, the ratings that they can pull. And we had higher ratings than any radio station in the entire Southeast back then. It was an incredible, incredible time to be alive, incredible time to be on the radio. You know, TMA was the big time. If you were a disc jockey, you wanted to get there.
A lot of people may be listening now, maybe some people that are my age or younger saying, well, yeah. Who cares? You know, it's just a news talk station. It's
AM station.
You know, but why should people care?
Well, I don't know why people should care today. I really don't. There's TV today, you know, but back then we were the personalities of the day. People actually listened to the radio not just for music, but also for the disc jockeys. You know, they're like, God, Gary London's on the radio now, you know, or Booby Nash, or you know, and these were names that people knew, and they knew them just as well as they knew members of their family, and they would tune in and they'd actually listen not only to the music, but also to the disc jockey.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. I'm going to ask you different questions of everybody else here. Anything else you want to add then, John?
It was a great time and still is. That's it.
WTMA, Charleston.